Okay, this is just a quick little tutorial or step by step for how to flash Quicksilver onto a Mobula6. I've actually got Quicksilver on here already, but I'll go through the processes and reflash it just to show how it's done. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, and the first thing I recommend, is to get Betaflight open, the Configurator, and make a backup of your original firmware and settings. So I've got a spare crazy B board that I'm going to plug in here. And we're going to go to connect, go to CLI, and do a diff all. Diff all, save to file. All right, so save that. And now I can disconnect and say bye bye, Betaflight. All right, so that's the backup. The next step is to download the configurator. I've got Windows, so I'm going to grab the Windows version and I'm going to put it here, which I already have, but I'm going to re-download it because he's just re-released a bunch of stuff. So download that. And now we're going to extract that. Extract here. Yes, replace. Okay, start up the configurator. You'll get this prompt. Just say yes, it's safe. And we've opened up a new page in our browser with the configurator open. So let's go to the flash page and plug in our. Right, we're in. And since I didn't use the DFU button, I'm going to reset the bootloader. And you can see that message saying no DFU device found has disappeared. And I'm ready to go. So I want NFE Quicksilver. I want release 1.00. It's the only one here. And now we're going to go into the target section. And because I have a crazy B F4 and I want to use the free sky protocol, which is just because I've got that on there, I'm going to select crazy B F4 brushless free sky hex and flash. It downloads it. And then it erases, and after that, it will do the write. You can actually see some of the process going on in the background with this little window. And back to the main window. Write and verify. Done. Firmware flashed, as you can see up here. And we've got a connect option up the top now. So now we're going to go connect. All right, I haven't done anything with this, so I'm going to go ahead and give my profile name Mobula6 Quicksilver and apply. And now we're going to go to the setup page. We need to go through each of the settings and set it up so that it matches what we've got. There's no real defaults on this. Okay, so I've got props out, so that's correct. I'm going to set my digital idle up to about 9 because I have stubborn motors. I want total throttle percent to 100 because this is a module 6. The default 10% doesn't really do much at all. So D shot 600, leave the rest here, voltage. Leave that as zero. And RX is not a serial receiver, unless you have a serial receiver. I don't have one on here, so I'm going. But I do have smart audio on USART 2, which is default for the Mobula6 board. And apply. Okay, refresh over here. And then we see smart audio is detected. 5865. Well, I'm not on A1, I like to be on R1, so I'll set the VTX channel 1 and power 1. That's how I have mine. So VTX is set up. Now I'm going to go to the rates tab. This is Silverware rates, because I'm used to Silverware. I like a little bit more. You've got better an option for better flight rates if you're used to better flight. I am used to this, so this is the next part. You need to set the PIDs up, because the PIDs are set for a 5-inch, and this is not a 5-inch. So go down to the drop down to PID preset, say 65mm brushless whoop, yep, and load. So that's important, you have to press load. And once that's loaded the numbers into here, I'm going to keep those as they are and hit apply. I'm going to leave the other settings here off for now. Same with the filters, they worked fine for me before. So that's all I've got to do on the rates tab. Go to the receiver. Yes, it's D8, and packet rate, I'm going to say this is direct. Apply. Now, you'll notice that it's bind saved, no, and status binding. Now, this is important because by default, it will go to auto bind every time you start up the quad, which is similar to what the Bayang, the Silverware quads used to do. So I'm going to go to on my receiver, on my transmitter, and I have this here as that. Now I'm going to go across and select bind. All right, you see that's now says RX status bound, so that's good. Now, I've suggested this needs to be on the needs to be a button on here, but for now you need to save the bind. So to save the bind, you need to go up, 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 and down, down, down. That's the save bind options, and by doing that, you can see now bind saved is set to yes. So now when I unplug the quad and connect it back up, it will be bound up to my transmitter again. All right, and receiver, bind saved, yes. RSSI is jumping all over the place. Thank you, Free Sky. And next up is the channel assignments. So I've got arming on channel 5, yes. I'm going to have level mode on channel 6. I'm just used to Silverware, so race mode on channel 7. Horizon mode on channel 8. And one important thing, turtle mode on. Now, this is a different thing better flight, because turtle mode is automatic on Quicksilver. You don't need to switch it on or off. So leave this as channel on to have turtle mode whenever you are upside down. Okay, so I've applied those. And next up, I'm going to the OSD tab. A few things here on the OSD. You need to do this manually. The call sign cannot be changed currently, but we can move things around using the steps here. I'm going to bring this to about there. All right, so I'm going to do that. Note that the font is left over from Betterflight, so you can see it's got the Betterflight logo here. You can upload a font similar to in Betterflight, but you don't need to. So here we go, apply. And now we go to the motor tab. I don't need to change that. I don't have a LiPo plugged in, so I'm going to keep it at that. And there we go, we're ready to go. We go back to the profile, and I'm going to save this profile as a JSON file so that I can use it for next time. So that's all I needed to do. I can disconnect this now, and we're set up with Quicksilver. Thanks for watching.